Well, we know because I was 6 weeks when I started filming, and then it was 38 weeks pregnant at the end.
Even longer than that? Because there was this moment. David and I did a pre-shoot day on a Friday, and it was down in the case, and we were working together, and we meant to start filming on the Monday. And on Sunday night, we got a call saying, this thing called COVID is really hitting. We're gonna shut down for a month.
2 weeks, we'll be good.
Exactly. Yeah. And I think it was how many months was it? 5 months?
3 months, 3-4 months.
If you're going back to Hogwarts, you've got to see it on the big screen. It's immersive, especially in IMAX. You know, you sort of, these huge screens allow you to fall into the story. And the great thing about seeing these stories collectively is you share the experience, I would say. It's like, for me, it's almost like going to church when you experience the wonderful experience together, things that are funnier are even funnier when you're laughing with another 200 people, and things are more moving when you share that moment with a big bunch of strangers. And I think that's the beauty of cinema, and I think that's why it will never go away, because those moments are amplified when we experience them together in a theater.
I heard an amen in the back once you said my own church.
The Gryffindor common room for me, it just seems really cozy. I like the vibe.
It's an obvious but a goodie, and we got to go in there for the first time on this movie, which is the Great Hall, and it was that was a pretty spine tingling day. That one. Yeah.
I got to eat breakfast, and it was delicious. It was really good.
Some little wizards and witches.
That was really cool, man.
Pint size.
Really pint size witches and wizards. That really solidified the fact that, wow, we are part of this Harry Potter universe.
Definitely.
And the food was delicious.
I play Professor Yolali Hicks. She is a charms professor at Ilvermorny, which is very exciting. And Ilvermorny being the North American Wizarding School. And she is someone who is recruited by Dumbledore to join his team of misfits to help, you know, defeat Grindelwald and move against Grindelwald. And what's great about her is I feel like she's really good at seeing to the heart of people. And I think that she's someone that you can really depend on. And she does some really cool magic in this.
Yeah. Now, William.
Well, as you know, when Yusuf Kama ended the last story, he was quite devastated. This is a man who's lost his mom, and then his dad, and then his sister. So he's not necessarily a happy person, not someone you would like to go on vacation with. Although I would, to cheer him up. In this one, what happened is that Yusuf has met people. This is someone who didn't trust anyone, who wasn't loved by anyone, and he's met a family. He's been rescued by Newt, and he found purpose with Dumbledore. Dumbledore gave him a family, and he's testing his ability to trust and eventually love. And by the way, he actually has a real family because he has a brother-in-law in Theseus. So, yeah, and he has a mustache.
Yes, so when I joined in the last film, it was always gonna expand Bunty's, you know, character, and it was really exciting to see how they were gonna do that. And, you know, she's very happy with the animals in the basement, but in this film, she gets a mission from Dumbledore, a very important mission. And the weight of the world is sort of on her shoulders, and I think she rises to the occasion without giving too much away.
It's so tough without giving away. You're like, did I do anything?
I know.
All right, so finally. Yeah.
That's awesome.
What did that mean to Jacob, and what did it mean to you?
Oh, yes. Yeah. It means as much to Jacob as it does to me. It's very special watching these wizards with their wands for the last two movies, longing for a wand. And it's like, you know, it's very, very special. They gave me no training, but I didn't want any. I didn't want any training. I'm a natural.
You went in blind.
Yeah.
Just gonna wing it.
Yeah, exactly. And that's a lot of the fun that comes out of the comedy that you see in the scenes in the movie where I'm trying to this muggle trying to figure out how to use this wand and not quite being able to control it, you know.
All right. So, as you know,
the Gryffindor common room for me, it just seems really cozy. I like the vibe.
It's an obvious but a goodie, and we got to go in there for the first time on this movie, which is the Great Hall, and it was a pretty spine tingling day. That one.
I got to eat breakfast, and it was delicious. It was really good.
Some little wizards and witches.
That was really cool, man.
Pint size.
Really pint size witches and wizards. That really solidified the fact that, wow, we are part of this Harry Potter universe.
Definitely.
And the food was delicious that I had.
I think you said that. Yeah. Kathy from Irvine wants to know.
I was actually just being nice and waiting. Polite.
She's so polite.
I filming in Berlin.
I can tell you which.
So incredible.
Sorry.
Yeah, I love filming in Berlin because the set was just so incredible. Yeah. Absolutely mind blowing.
Yes, that.
What she said.
What she said. Now, I was going to say that I can't tell which was the best scene for me to film, but I can tell you which was the saddest, and that was the final one.
Did you have a mustache?
I didn't want it to stop. I kept the mustache as a souvenir in a box.
I hope the wrong person doesn't find that.
All right.
Oh, nobody. There's no opportunity in this to break the wands, because I think... Like, Daniel Radcliffe must have broken a million wands, right? That's where that's coming from.
You gotta think.
But now it's like, they give you the wand in a briefcase, right?
It's like James Bond.
They literally come and whip it.
And then they take it from you. And I've definitely tried, David, I did try to steal some wands, but I unfortunately was not able to.
But the case is one of those sort of stainless steel cases that you see in kind of heist movies, in which, you know, or Bond movies, in which sort of... Q comes and brings the thing. They're pretty well protected.
All right, maybe.
Oh, if you're going back to Hogwarts, you've got to see it on the big screen. It's immersive, especially in IMAX. You know, you sort of these huge screens allow you to fall into the story. And the great thing about seeing these stories collectively is you share the experience. I would say it's like, for me, it's almost like going to church when you experience. The wonderful experience together, things that are funnier are even funnier when you're laughing with another 200 people, and things are more moving when you share that moment with a big bunch of strangers. And I think that's the beauty of cinema, and I think that's why it will never go away, because those moments are amplified when we experience them together in a theater.
I heard an amen in the back once you said my own church.
Well, we know because I was 6 weeks when I started filming, and then it was 38 weeks pregnant at the end.
Even longer than that? Because there was this moment. David and I did a pre-shoot day on a Friday, and it was down in the case, and we were working together, and we meant to start filming on the Monday. And on Sunday night, we got a call saying, this thing called COVID is really hitting. We're going to shut down for a month.
2 weeks, we'll be good.
Exactly. Yeah. And I think it was how many months was it? 5 months?
3 months, 3-4 months.
Wow. All right, so everybody excited?
Yeah.
Everybody in North America ready to experience this movie in IMAX?
Yes.
Yes. All right, now, everyone in the audience.
Lumos?
Yeah.
We're doing a Lumos?
Yeah, let's just start it off and get this going. Like,
okay, so.
Did I just steal your wand, man? You know what, they didn't.
Classic. You didn't get a wand.
You can have mine. Give me a wand.
Here we go. Okay, do a Lumos Maxima.
Yes.
Is that good? Okay, on the count of three. You guys game?
Oh, sure.
One, two, three.
Lumos Maxima!
All right, a huge thank you to David Yates, the entire cast.